it's a living museum filled with hundreds of acres of trees, shrubs, and plants for everyone to explore.
And Eileen Whalen is live at the National Arboretum with more. Eileen.
Guys, this is such a great assignment, and seriously, what perfect weather. We've got the nice breeze. So earlier we showed you how to prune your azaleas, and now we're talking grass. We're at the grassroots exhibit here at the Arboretum, part of the U.S. Department of Agriculture. Jeff Reinhart is the grassroots coordinator. So tell us about the grassroots exhibit here.
Well, the grassroots exhibit is newly built. We just built it last summer, opened it in the fall, and so we've had a lot of people come out here, especially in the spring when the temperatures were a little bit milder.
Uh-huh.
But we've got different displays showing ornamental grasses, showing sports fields, best management practices for lawns, golf courses, and we've got a different varieties from all over the country, really, including those that do best here in the D.C. area.
Yeah, this really is nice. So this is the ornamental grass right here. This is really lovely. But, you know, I think a lot of people are thinking, you know, about their lawns right now. We got so much rain last week. How do you really preserve your grass, you know, to really make it that nice, lush green?
Sure. Well, the rain last week definitely helped, since we had a drier and warmer May than we usually do. Mm-hmm. So there's a couple tips. One of them is to mow higher. So usually for tall fescue, which is what we have over here,
uh-huh,
we usually recommend to mow at about 3 inches. So you can see right here,
okay,
you know, we're right at about 3 inches. So
now, most lawnmowers, do they have, I mean, you can tell, obviously, I don't mow the lawn, but do, I mean, can you specify the length?
You kind of have to measure it yourself.
Okay.
So I would put it on a sidewalk and then, mm-hmm, measure it yourself.
Okay.
And then that's the way you know where your setting is. Each lawnmower is going to be a little bit different. But mowing higher really helps the root development, which helps during the summer, so you have deeper roots and you don't have to water as much.
Okay, awesome. Now, you guys also have turf. I know, you know, this stuff gets a little bit hot in the summertime. I know about turf. I got a fiance that coaches soccer, and he brings in all those little pellets into the house.
Exactly.
Woo, I need a new vacuum cleaner.
You can see the synthetic turf here.
Uh-huh.
So that, you know, they have the chrome rubber pellets and sand mixed into that.
Yeah, that's
so
the stuff that's always on the carpet.
Yep. So here's in our display here, we have a representation of the synthetic versus natural grass, which is, in our case, Bermuda grass.
Uh-huh.
This is latitude 36, which is what they use on the field at FedEx for the Redskins.
They use this natural grass?
They use the same natural grass here, same variety. And so this is what's used for football fields, soccer fields. And it's really good because it's dense,
uh-huh,
it takes traffic really well, and it takes the heat really well, too.
I was going to say, because you don't have then the pellets, and that's what really absorbs and kind of radiates off that heat.
Exactly. So with the natural grass field, it's going to be a lot cooler during summer months,
mm-hmm,
but it's a living system as opposed to just,
yeah,
plastic. So, you know, you're getting release of oxygen, filtering any, you know, rainwater, you're filtering that through the system. So it's a lot, in my opinion, it's a lot better surface.
Wonderful. Jeff, thank you so much for some great information. Come to see him at the grassroots exhibit at the National Arboretum. So much to see, guys, and we're going to be talking about some more plants, actually, in our 9 o'clock hour. Larry and Kelly, back to you.